Alright guys, welcome to Choose Your Own Path. So we're on the second part of it, of painting, though I'd paint it without you. Sorry guys, been having issues with stuff going on my camera. So this is where we're at with it. I got the frog painted out. And yeah, so it's just going to dry, because that right there has a lot of paint in it. I wanted to put a big blob. And what I'm going to do with that is now when I epoxy it, I'm going to be able to put a blob of epoxy on it and it'll make the round eye. Let me know what you think, guys. I like it. I'm sure my buddy will like it. All right, stay tuned. I'll video that later.
Hey, guys. Welcome to Choose Your Own Path. Let me see. What day is it today? It's Thursday and I'm off. Love it. So I ended up at the cabin, went and picked up my wife because she was there for a couple days, went and dropped off a couple things, came back, and it was hot. Holy cow, it was hot. And I'm drinking coffee. Alright, let's get into this video. So, I just showed you guys the frog that I carved. Now, what I like to do is, the guy that I'm giving this to, he looks like... Now, I don't know the reference, but there was an old movie called Papillon. Guy went to jail, had these little glasses. I don't know, something stupid funny, but he looks like him, so I called him Papillon all the time. Papillon, again, get away from me, fly. Papillon is a butterfly in French, and I'm French. So, what I want to do is cut out a papillon, a butterfly. Yes, that's what we're going to do today. So, just a little chunk of cottonwood that I had extra, you know, still a good piece, but it's smaller, so we're going to go with that. All we're going to do is, I ended up, there's a fly around here and he's bugging me. All we're going to do is we're going to cut him out, and then we're going to shave him out. We're going to stick him up here. I like it, you like it, we all like it. Let's do it. So, we are going to use our cut saw. I'll have the link in the description below if you want to look for them. Using the promo code RVWoodCraft, all in capital. Save yourself a couple bucks. Keep on saying it, we'll do it again. All right, so let's check this out. I'm gonna bring it down. What we're gonna do, first of all, is we're just gonna cut on the outside line. We're gonna get them out. We're gonna go deep. All right. What I mean by deep is we want to get as much out of it. So then after that, we can do the feathering of how small and how thin we want it. Let's go. So you can see that we ended up cutting pretty deep. Now we want to get rid of everything around it, but we're not going to take, you know, our other cut saws and scrape it out. What we're going to do is we're just going to cut these lines straight through. I might go a little bit deeper here, just because I see it's not deep enough. I want to get a lot of the butterfly out, like I said, so that we can work on it how thin we want to go. Let's keep on going. With that. So now what we're going to do is we're just going to take our saw. All right. So, you know what I mean? I just wanted to cut those ends out. Now what I could do is just sort of cut the corners. We could probably even take the top off a bit.
Let's see if we can do that.
All right. So we can work with that now. Now what we're going to do is we're going to shave all the way around it, so we just have the butterfly. All right, let's get that going. So now we know we have our butterfly. What I'm going to do is I'm going to keep the thickness of this so that I can actually hold on to it better, where it's not just a little piece. And I'm going to do the detailing. Now, detailing is I'm going to leave this butt part up, and then this guy is going to be
pushed in more. Just the way it is. This is my butterfly. All right, let's do it. Okay, we're also going to get out the body. Very simple. Simple butterfly, okay? Now, what we want to do is we want to know how thick we want to get it, right? So, decide on your piece how big your butterfly wants to be. So, I mean, this guy, I gotta look at it myself. That's a nice size butterfly. It probably could be brought down just a little smaller. Butterflies are bigger than frogs. Frogs are bigger than butterflies. Whatever we want. So what we could do is we'll just trim out, we'll thin them out just a bit, just a tiny bit, guys. Not, we don't want to go crazy, right? So let's do that. So once you're happy with what you got, I think the next step is to get the butterfly out of this block. To get them out of the block now, we got to figure out how thick we want. So what I did was I kept the second piece, or the piece attached, right? Which is good. So all I want to do is cut them straight out. Now, a couple ways you could do it. You could just use the cuts all, keep on digging it through. Bigger piece. I like my fingers. Ain't going to do that. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to the saw, but we're going to have to use something a lot thinner. Now, I'm thinking we're going to just use a hacksaw blade. It'll cut through wood. It'll not cut through metal. We're just going to cut them on the edge of here. Even if he rounds out a bit, that's fine. We're okay with that. All right. So we cut out the back to the thickness we want. Now we got to take off all this stuff, which is like easy as that. So we're going to do that now. Watch your fingers. What we're going to do, though, is we're going to keep a good chunk of the back on. So what we're going to do after that is we're going to put a nail in it so that we can stick it and it'll have more of a base to it. So I'll show you what I mean. All right, guys. So there's our butterfly. And he's roughly about, we'll say about 3 millimeters thick. Just remember when you're using cottonwood, eh? Very easy to snap. So you don't want to go too thin. And that's a rule of thumb. Some guys can make these things paper thin and really last and really look good. Just as an example, you guys got to remember, it's the illusion of the butterfly being thin, putting up on the wall. As long as you do a nice little sanding and a detailing and painting, it's going to look great. Well, this might look great. I'll let you know. You let me know. So, that's what we're gonna do, is we're gonna sand them. And we'll put a little bit of detail. And we're gonna paint them. Simple. Maybe to you, not to me. But remember, if I could do it, you can do it. That's the way it goes, brother. Okay, so we'll continue. Go from there. All right, guys, so what we did was we ended up putting lines on it. We sanded it down. So we're just gonna go ahead and use this one of these little cheap things. And we're just gonna cut out some lines. So we're just doing some lines like that to open it up. Maybe like look like they're part of the butterfly itself. Now the next thing I just wanna do is I wanna put little indents all around. So you see that? We're not gonna worry about the back because the back will not be seen at all. Being on the wall, we're not gonna worry. So what we want to do is just shape out the head a bit. Then we can play around with it because we're gonna put two antennas in here. So I'm just gonna dig two little holes on the top. I'm happy with this. So I'm just going to give it a light sanding, is we're going to paint it. And that will be another video. All right? Keep on watching, guys. I'm not done.